All right, new at five. It's a word so long, you've got to read it slowly. So here it goes. Biomechatronics. It's a science field that tries to combine biology, mechanical engineering, electronics with robotics tossed in.
It sounds complicated, but some brainy kids here in Central Florida are taking it on. West 2's Dave McDaniel spoke to eighth graders who are more than dreaming. They are designing that dream and what it might look like.
Estimate for the surgery for just putting in the os design of almost $300,000.
Only 21 herself and briefing eighth graders on her difficult medical journey.
So it doesn't count the neurosurgeon. She had 3 open brain surgeries.
I thought what better way to kind of inspire them is to share my story.
Sharing with a group of Markham Woods Middle School eighth graders how their foray into biomechatronics might help the next person who needs a prosthetic skull or some other high-tech creation after the removal of brain tumors or any other difficult challenge.
What are some of the tests that you took?
I've always wanted to help people, and I feel like this is the best way I can.
13 years old in this challenging class, thinking medicine's in her future.
There was this incident and I ended up at the hospital. It was nothing big, but I remember feeling scared. I wanted to help others who feel scared to feel less afraid.
The students are tasked to use critical thinking to solve complex problems, even going as far to write a grant proposal to get the necessary funds to build a prototype.
We're kind of doing it on our own and really thinking to ourselves, how are we going to fix this problem?
That students will learn how to use computational thinking skills and critical thinking skills to solve real-world problems.
The students apply to be part of the very small class, then they collaborate, then dream, with the only limit being what they can actually design and create.
They're going to explore 3D printing organs. They're going to explore whatever technology, biotechnology, that's out there to come up with a solution for the problem.
The students are also instructed how to apply for grants, present those with grants available.
Do the research and find the supplies, create a budget, write a grant, and order their supplies in order to create their prototype.
They just give us a problem and we have to figure out new and inventive ways to solve it.
The students need to be self-reliant.
I don't guide their thoughts. I might help them find their direction, but it really does come from the students. It's more student-led than teacher-led.
This generation now, it could definitely make an impact.
In Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.
And you have to hear this. Down the road, there are researchers who believe that organs can be 3D printed using cells from a host patient. Just imagine that possibility.